jaw, precision, wit, creativity. Over the past 4 years, Lip Sync for Your Life has seen each of these qualities in abundance. But what makes all the star? Why all of these things? All of these things and more. Welcome to the finale of Reddit's Lip Sync for Your Life All Stars. I'm your host, Miss Marcella Fox. So, in fifth place, we have Coco. Coco, I think of you as the dancing diva of Lip Sync for Your Life. I just do. I think a lot of people think of you that way. And I was really glad when you decided to compete in All Stars because, guess what? No eliminations. You can give your dancing gig, which everyone lives for, but you can show us what else too. And you did it fearlessly. I felt like when I was watching you, I felt like you'd been set free. That's what it felt like. I lived so much watching you this season. Every week, you just redefined what the Coco brand was. You gave something new and unexpected, but always stayed true to yourself. Your drag suicide video is one for the time capsule, girl. It's up there with Calypso's I Will Survive, Glorious Finale, everything Edie did. It's there. It's one of the best videos to ever grace our little subreddit. It just is. So I think you should be incredibly proud. Fifth place, well done, girl. I mean, it shows. It shows. You should be really proud, and I hope to see more of you in the future. The All-Star finishing in fourth place is Lifa Linjection. Lethal Injection, when you came into All Stars, you stated that every week you were going to give it your all, you were going to be the best Lethal you can. And guess what, girl? Mission accomplished! You did that! Seriously, every week you gave it a look! Oh my god, the looks. Can we just talk about the looks? Every week you gave it a look, a concept, you knew what you were doing. You always have this really good attention to detail, an eye for nuance. You have this swagger, this way of holding yourself, which I wish I had. If you could bottle that up and sell it, you'd be fucking rich, girl. Seriously, I just think you go from strength to strength. That's what you've done this season. In season 4, you had, like, I've always described it as a roller coaster. But this time you were, like, Miss Consistent. Fuck Miss Congeniality, you were Miss Consistentiality. That's what you were, girl. Anyway, I always look forward to seeing what you have next up your sleeve. I'm always excited by what Lethal Injection has to bring. And I can't wait to see where you go from here. Strength to strength, girl, really. Well done. Finishing in third place, we have Harper Valley.
Harper Valley PTA! Season 2! Represent! Okay, so Harper, it means a lot to me to be able to talk about you because back in season 2, you were fierce competition to me. We had a healthy, competitive relationship. And now over the years, I feel like I've gotten to know you in a more genuine way and I feel really close to you. We talk a lot. And you're one of my best friends, so let's get to it. In season 2, you changed the game for everybody. I mean, on a technical level, for sure. Green screen, animation, sewing up your dress, makeup, for sure. Makeup ability, taken to a new level. Your videos are ambitious on this level that has made everyone around you have to step up their game. And I don't know if you give yourself enough credit for that. Whether it's Snow White realness or Linda Blair realness, your concepts are always good and kind of like unexpected, which is like just so much fun. And I don't think you give yourself enough credit for the amazing creative person that you are. I know that you think that your videos haven't met your expectation for yourself during this All-Star season, but that's just because you have crazy expectations for yourself because you're on another level and you need to realize that. And if there's one thing that's undeniable, it's that you're an All-Star. Nobody else continues to make videos after an earthquake happens, girl. That's you. You got the drive and ambition. You challenge yourself. And it is amazing, and I'm in awe of you. And that's all I have to say. I think that you're a stellar person, and you should be incredibly proud of all the work that you've done, both in season 2 and now.
Now we're down to our final two, Dor Pantera and Sumix. And because I'm a particularly cruel drag queen, as you all well know, we're gonna talk to each of them and then announce the winner afterwards. Sorry, not sorry.
Apologies for the boxes, I am moving like immediately. Anyway, Sumix, I am now talking about you and what a joy you are and have been throughout this competition. You served everything we could have asked for and more. Like, a continuous plot line throughout some of your videos. Weirdly incredible technical skills, like just production values through the roof. Real acting, drag, not drag, multiple characters, scary, funny, sexy, all of it. You gave us everything, and it's been a joy to watch you, and I'm so glad that you're here, on this planet. I'm glad you're here on this planet, but I'm also glad you're here in the competition, and, you're wonderful. I just adore you. But again, I am a host and the mother of this house, and I love you all equally. So, Sumix, I love you as much as everybody else, which is a lot.
Oh,
Dor Panthera! Season 2? Oh my god. Dor, I'm so excited to be able to talk about what you've done and everything. Back in season 2, you were delivering really, really, really good videos. I mean, most notably, probably the You Spin Me Round video that I think everybody really enjoys and is regarded as one of our better videos overall. Now, All Stars has come along and you spun things right round again, girl. I'm talking about perception. Goodness. I think in this season you've delivered your best videos. Your absolute best. And not only that, you've really proven your place as an all-star. I think that your videos exemplify why we've stuck with the one-take method, because you've made magic this season, this all-star season. Your videos all have this tremendous sense of humor. They're so funny and charming. But I think that your video that you made for The Fear is your best video. And not only that, I genuinely think it's the best video of the season and the best, one of the best videos that's ever been submitted, ever, to the subreddit. Ever, ever, ever. I don't have a list, but top three, probably. I don't know. It's just astounding and beautiful, and I watch it all the time. Anyway, all that to say, I think you should be incredibly proud of all of the work you've done. You were great then, you're even better now, and you should just sit back and really just take the time to appreciate how amazing you are. You should be proud of all the growth you've had and the videos you've submitted. A-R-T, art. Okay? Very, very proud to have seen what you've done this year, and congratulations on your performance.
Okay, it's finally the point we've all been waiting for. It's time to announce the winner of All Stars. Are you ready? I am. Okay. The winner of Reddit's Lip Sync for Your Life All Stars, the first ultimate All Star, and the person who accumulated the most votes this season is Dor Panthera. Well done, Dor. You have done a phenomenal job this season, and each of our hosts have a message for you.
Dorp, congratulations! Holy shit, you were good this season. You were always good, but these videos stepped things up. Everyone was a complete package, a total concept, just crazy great. You are such an expressive, charismatic performer, and such a creative, visionary mind, and it was all awesome, and you deserve this, and I think that you are impressive. You are amazing. I adore you. You're an all-star. Mwah. Mwah!
Congratulations to my season 2 sister! You did an amazing job this year. And you should be proud of yourself. And I love you. And yay! Never forget who actually won season 2. Just kidding. That's horrible.
Okay, that's a wrap. We have our winner. And what a winner we have. Well done again to Dor. And well done to everyone. All 12 of you. You have made this season phenomenal. Incredible. You've set a new standard for all future competitors. I hope you know that. I really want you all to stick around for the future, because having you here, you know, bringing back people from the dead, it's been amazing. And I know that if you stick around for season 5, which I really hope you do, and comment and everything, it will just enrich the whole experience. Speaking of season 5, I hope to see you all in the summer, where I'll be hosting said season. I can't wait for it, and I will see you all then. Take care, everyone. Bye.